Hello boys and girls, welcome to peek over my shoulder as I figure out Oblivion lost once again. And we are in Pripyat and I cannot remember shit. What else is new? Okay, apparently I didn't have any saves from the last session. And I know why, because in unmodded game there's this bug that corrupts saves if you attempt saving in Pripyat. But apparently they have fixed it here, so I think I'm gonna be so bold and try some saves. Also, I wonder, can I get up there? I mean, I came from up there, because that's the... No. That's the way into Twilight Zone. Also, haha, texture gap. That was just the humor. Oh, hello! So, is that... I think that's duty with that, keeping that corpse company. Isn't it? Oh, it's freedom! No, I don't know. Well, last time in Pripyat, I didn't manage to get up there. I mean, all the way up there. Even. Let me try for a little warm up. Oh, okay, you know I'm on the other side of the invisible barrier, aren't I? So let's hop over. No, I said let's hop over. Seriously, dude, who are you? Ah, loner. I take it. Because he ain't shooting at me and he's still low. So let's see if I go up there to the stash area. From there, I hop up there. Then up there. Maybe some other time, and in my own, time. Anyway, it has been months since I was last here. I checked and my last recording was from October last year. Oh boy, I hope the rifle range doesn't reach the Twilight Zone. Okay, here we have the Kool-Aid Man graffiti. Here we have the backworlds where reality is broken. Here we have the invisible walls. They can't see me, so I'm safe. Now, let's see, what am I carrying? Okay, ammo. Okay, let's switch to rifles. And, now I forgot what I was gonna say. So anyway, I would have to repeat some of the steps that I did here. Also, I would have to avoid the NPP level changer. Not because, well, not because I can't return. That's again a new addition that you can, but I suspect that entering the NPP, even if you return, would trigger some storyline stuff, which I would rather not trigger right now. Whee! Okay, now how it goes on, because we are near the level changing territory. Let me try it. Quick save. Oh, I love the flickering bits like this. It's like it's a bit of this uncertainty and sort of, I don't know, a certain Twilight Zone charm. No, where were we? Okay, at this angle we can view that. Would anybody make a new mod at some point where the new structure or the new sarcophagus will be featured? Well, probably not, because it's a, it would be an alternate timeline anyway, but it would be a little bit, it's kind of cool, I would think. Whoa, shit! Oh, such a rookie mistake. Okay, let's reload. Okay, so HUD remains on. The flickering window looks as if somebody was welding in there. I'm pretty sure he said it last time. Okay, if I move from this side, then... Oh yeah, shit. Today. Right, where were we? Okay, the flickering window, and let's circle around back here. I forgot that the level changer wasn't marked, at least on the minimap. Okay, should be past it now, so I can start circling back again. Also, boys and girls, when in Twilight Zone, always check your ground. Oh yeah, that's the stadium there. Okay. Let me just quick save again. Before. It was this house box, wasn't it? Or was I further away? Oh, the house is solid on this side. Go figure. Okay, I am not gonna poke too much because I don't want to fall through any textures or anything. Okay, but now it's safe to turn the HUD off. Whee! Trust this ground. Oh, okay, the border goes here. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Yep, even the bolts go right through. It's like the sinking water from one of my childhood movies. Said that. Pardon the excitement, it has been a while. Thing is that last time when I did some recording, it was because there was a longer pause in testing Lost Alpha, that is, and what now? Level changer? Whoa, she just froze on me. Thou shalt not take the name of Lost Alpha in vain. Anyway, last time I took some time to record was when there was a longer pause between the builds of Lost Alpha and when the active testing began again. Then I took a break from this because I don't want to mix the two S.T.A.L.K.E.R. versions, because, well, they are different, but they are similar enough to sort of crosswire my brain. And that is all I have to say about that. Okay, now if I recall, there was a controller not far from here, so I'm gonna make a manual save here. Whee! Now let me just start a whole new batch. Okay. I always forget which keys work and which don't. Okay. Although, for the controller, I think the regular rounds make more sense. Except I don't know where the controller is, I only remember there was a proximity alert. And, well, I would say that the controller effect is a very well implemented game design element in general, but in Oblivion Lost, where controllers are much stronger than in vanilla, it's bordering on brilliant. Thing is that, well, usually when there are mutants and bad shit going down, then all this is happening to your character, and while you are sitting safely at the computer and you're able to make decisions and do shit. But with a controller, the brain fog effect is so strong, the audio effect messes up not just the actor but the player as well. Hello, I am inside crown. You cannot see me. Woo! Huh? Actually, that was the same. That's the hotel, isn't it? So that was the same monolith that killed me off last time. I was having a bit of a reckless standoff with a monolith sniper, and in this very building, actually. And can I still? And well, I stuck my head out too far and was promptly dealt with. Okay, so the controller was more on this way, I suppose. Can I take out some more monolith while I'm at it? Okay, that's a chimney or something. Air vent. Whatever. Oh, okay, now I'm behind the kindergarten and the controller was somewhere here. Of course, I moved at different speeds, so I'm guessing might be somewhere else as well. Anybody up there? Oh, here we go.